you have one on your side, stowed away at the minute, but if you bend your feet all the way backwards, it's not the first one. So be careful. Be careful with that.
So basically, just don't move.
Don't move. Don't breathe. Strobe is on. Vapor lock jump. Mag 1 and mag 2. Clear flat. Brakes are on.
Can you hear me alright?
Yep.
Now this microphone is quite sensitive, so the further away from your mouth it is, the less and less I can hear you.
Okay.
So you want to make sure it's nice and close to your lips.
Can you hear me?
I can hear you perfect. Okay, controls are full and free. Choke is off, giving us full power. My harness and hatch are secure, your harness and hatch are secure. Instruments, airspeed, vertical speed and altimeter are set for departure. RPM gauge is working, we're on the right frequency, transponder is on, temperatures and pressures are all good, quick dead cut on the mags are working, fuel sufficient for the flight, flaps are set, trim the aircraft ready for takeoff, takeoff weight, you class as half a person, are you okay? You class as half a person when we refer to as weight, are you okay with that? Yeah, most women are. Now we're just going to taxi ourselves down to the other end of the runway. You boy? Okay, wind is in with inlets. Otherwise, it's going to be a little bit bumpy as we get close to the ground. As we climb through that friction layer, it should start to smooth down. There is going to be an element of bumping around.
It's all part of the fun.
That's right. That's the downside of being in a light aircraft.
So, do you fly the flex wing as well?
I do. Yeah.
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 I still want to do that.
Oh, you should do. It's absolutely awesome. It's just a little bit too windy for the for the flex wing today. Not so much with the crosswind because obviously the wind's down the strip. But if you take off and the wind's stronger than you go forwards, you go backwards.
Right.
The higher we go, the stronger the winds. You see, this aircraft has a lot more wider weather window for us to play with.
So how high do we get?
We're going to vary. A good safety height for us is going to be above 1,500 feet. We can fly up to 5,500 feet before we're in airspace.
Right.
So that's just over a mile high.
Yeah.
We run out of oxygen around about 10,000 feet, so we won't be going that high.
No.
And really, we fly safe, so we aren't going to fly through a cloud, but we might go up and have a look at some of the clouds whilst we're up there.
Yeah.
So really, if the cloud base is too thick, then you can't get through it, so that can also be a limiting factor. Darley 1 traffic, Golf Tango Zulu holding runway 194 departure. Okay, now we're down this end, just going to go through a few pre-flight checks, making sure everything's okay. Trim is set for takeoff, temperatures and pressures are good, we're all set. Aux pumpers on, landing light is on. Okay, I'm good to go, you're good to go? Darley 1 traffic, Golf Tango Zulu, landing up runway 19. So we're off on the brakes to start us moving. Here's our runway. Okay, you ready for this?
Yeah, go for it.
So we're going straight through to full power. aircraft goes light, and we take off. Get some airspeed, and the aircraft climbs away.
This is fab.
Yeah, good fun. First safety height, so we can ease the power back. Second safety height, we can lose the flaps. Nose comes down, we can increase our airspeed. Now, look out directly ahead. Have you picked a spot to look at? Okay, here we go.
You must love this. It's a job.
I've had worse jobs. This is my reward. How you feeling, all right?
Yeah, loving it.
If you look back now, you can see our airfield where we took off from.
Oh yeah.
Looks tiny now, doesn't it?
It does.
Little specks of people. We're just over 1,000 feet above the ground.
Is that, that's not Carsington, is it?
It is Carsington. Yeah.
Wow.
Well done. That's where we're, we'll tootle off over in that direction. Darley Moor traffic, Golf Tango Zulu is climbing through 1900 feet, departing to the north of the Carsington. That's it, we're airborne. We're now 2,000 feet. It's smoothed down quite considerably, so we can ease the power down. There's Ashbourne, just on your side.
Yeah.
Is that the way you came in?
Yeah.
It's amazing that such a small town can have so much traffic.
Yeah. What's the furthest you go? The longest trip?
Longest flight we'll do is around about an hour.
Yeah.
We do also sell some of our cross-country flights, so we'll take off and go to another airfield.
All right.
Have a bacon butty and fly back.
Brilliant.
They're good fun.
Yeah.
It's a good way of seeing the country, you know. Well, we'll take off from here and do a nice big loop and head over towards sort of Shropshire, or we'll head over to the other side of Mansfield and you know, sort of Chesterfield and that sort of way. But one of these things with the fuel capacity and fuel burn on this thing, it's a great little touring aircraft.
Yeah.
So me and another instructor flew down to an airfield called Popham, which is right by the Isle of Wight. So we took off from here, an hour and a half later we're in the Isle of Wight. We had a bacon butty and a sandwich and a brew, and then we flew back.
Wow.
One tank of fuel.
Great way to spend a day.
Yeah, it was good. Also, taken off from here, and we flew all the way over to Wales, crossed over the Bristol Channel, and went down to Newquay.
Yeah.
That was quite a long trip. That was about 2.5 hours, but yeah, good fun. The beauty with these is you can get yourself up, even just for a flight, for, you know, sort of 20 minutes, half an hour, and have a really good time. It gets quite addictive, though, so
I bet. Well, when I had the call from, was it Jude?
Judy, yeah.
Yeah, this morning, the thought of not going up today made me think, I'll just go for this anyway, and then I can always, because this was given to me as a present
for
my birthday. But if I like it, and I know I knew I would, then I can get the other one as well, just purchase that myself, so.
The flex wing is a completely different experience. Although you're still in the same air, and you'll probably see very similar sort of things, it's a completely different experience. Mm. This is a lot like flying a sports car. You know, it's very controllable. You can put it exactly where you want it to. You can really throw it around. Whereas the flex wing's a lot like being on a motorbike, you know, and it's just completely different. Yeah, good fun.
Well, is it more exhilarating or?
It's different. I fly pretty much everything that we've got there, and I get a different thrill from each thing. And certainly when I'm doing personal flying, when I'm doing my flying for enjoyment.
Yeah.
You know, I'll be in the mood to fly one thing as opposed to another, you know.
So that bumping is just to the air pockets, isn't it?
That's exactly yeah. You see the sun shining, heating up the grass.
Yeah.
Releases all the moisture, and that moisture rising air is what gives us a lump. Now they can be as big as a bubble, as big as a field. Or they can be a great big column as big as a county.
Wow.
You know, it's just depends on the weather, really. There's Carsington Water. I love seeing Carsington Water from altitude.
It's a totally different shape, isn't it, what you think it is.
And you can see the valley, how before it was flooded. See how it's just dropping away?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, really deep.
Are gorgeous, aren't they?
Yeah.
Yeah, I bought my husband a flying lesson for his birthday a couple of years ago, and he loved it, and I said, my turn next. Not necessarily, it didn't have to be a flying lesson, but...
just want you to go up.
Yeah. So I've got this, I've got a Segway ride, and I've got a balloon ride all this month.
Wow.
Got more birthday presents.
Are you one of those that's got to go out and do things?
No, I turned 50 at Christmas last year, so this is a 50 things at 50 challenge that I've got for myself. So.
Brilliant.
Yeah.
I love that.
So they have to fall into one of four categories, either something that's new,
yeah,
something that's a challenge,
mm-hmm.
Something that is a trip down memory lane, so I'm doing lots of things going back to my past and places where I used to grow up. And the other one is just doing some me time, just make sure I have a good work-life balance, really.
Yeah, yeah. I love that, that's a great idea. And there's Matlock just there on our left-hand side.
Ah.
You see in the valley, see the castle on top of the hill?
Nope. In the wrong
you see
place.
The valley that's there?
Yeah.
Looking on the right-hand side of the valley, the sun's just shining.
Oh, yes,
on the,
yes, yeah, I can see it, yeah. Right, you see that flat field with like two tones, like
yeah,
big
yeah.
square? I think that's where we live, just the other side of that, because we live right above Matlock. Just next to Beely Moor, which is just further across. That's actually classed as Darley Moor, believe it or not, but you won't see it on any maps.
Oh, right. Darley Moor or Darley...
Darley Moor, yeah.
Are you joking?
Our address is Darley Moor, but people think it's where...
We
yeah,
are.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, there's no actually place called Darley Moor there. It's just the airfield.
No.
Darley Moor Airfield. A lot of people make the mistake of go to Darley Dale, which is, again, nowhere near.
Yeah. I didn't know that existed. That must be some kind of quarry, is it?
Yeah, obviously Matlock was just riddled with quarries.
Is that that's Cromford then?
Yeah.
This is amazing.
I'm just gonna zigzag so I can get the Matlock on the camera for you.
getting my bearings, I think we're probably further over that way where
right.
we live, yeah.
I was just pushing it to see if we could get there.
Yeah.
Have you got your bearings yet?
Sorry?
Have you got your bearings yet?
Pretty much, yeah. We're kind of 4 miles directly northeast of
right.
Matlock itself, so we're over there somewhere.
Yeah.
But you don't have to go that far if you can't.
Yeah, we'd still get there and back again.
Yeah, that's
in
fine.
Time.
Fair enough. It's just great seeing Matlock, actually.
Yeah, it's nice. You didn't see, I realise how many houses are built out of the local stone.
Yeah.
I still can't get over how busy Matlock Bath gets. It's so sought after. It is Gulliver's Kingdom
oh, yeah.
just over there. Are we going to get you do some flying?
Sorry?
Are we going to get you do some flying?
Oh, am I allowed?
Of course you are. All I want you to do is grab hold of this foam bit that's there. And the first thing I want you to do is just get used to how that aircraft feels without us doing anything.
Yeah.
See the horizon over there?
Yeah.
And all I want you to do is manage the horizon. So when the aircraft moves like that, bring the nose back up again. That's it. And release. If the aircraft goes like this, we roll it back to the left. So all we're doing is managing the horizon. See how we're doing that? That's it. And back to neutral. So whenever you do a movement, you want to be back to center. So we can minimize the effects on the control. That's it.
Isn't it
is very responsive. Minimal inputs, that's all you need. You see the windmills that are just here on our right hand side?
Ooh.
The four wind towers?
Yeah.
Okay, let's do a right hand turn and we'll put them on your side so you can get used to turning the aircraft. That's it. Roll the wings level there for me. That's it. Bit more. Look at your horizon. Make it nice and level. That's it.
Oops.
Well done.
Am I making it move so much, or is it the air pocket?
It's just the environment bouncing us around. It's quite a blustery day today. Combine that with some of the thermals as well makes it quite interesting. Good fun.
Wasn't expecting this.
I'm just bringing us up to the clouds. I'm gonna stick our head up above the clouds, see what's going on.
Sorry?
We're just going to stick our head up above the clouds, see what's going on.
You want me to?
Yeah. So bring the stick back.
Oh.
You have control. Bring the stick back. Increase the power. Aircraft's going to start climbing. Bring the nose up. That's it.
right amount?
Yeah, that's good. You can do a little bit more if you like. That's it.
Oops. Is that me?
No, we're all right. I'll have a look over there. I'll take over just
okay.
Temporarily.
Yeah, yeah, that's fine. The clouds are sitting on a shelf, isn't it? They're
it
kind
is.
Of flat.
Yeah, well, that's a temperature difference.
Yeah.
You'll notice that the air, it should go on a little bit cooler now.
Yeah, definitely notice the temperature change.
Look at that. Up in the clouds.
Wow. So that if there's more than one of you up here, then you go different directions?
Yes, but there's also a lot of other airfields about, so
yeah.
A lot of the times we use Mark 1 eyeball so that we don't fly into anybody. The other
yeah.
thing that we also use, obviously, we've got a transponder here which transmits our altitude, our location and height.
Yeah.
We have at the front there what's called a PCAS, and that transmits and that receives.
Right. So is there some kind of warning if you're close to someone else? Yeah. It's like you're doing a wheelie.
Yeah. Okay, time to come down. Ready for some negative G?
Yeah. Woo! Excellent.
Yeah, positive G. Ooh. They're a roller coaster ride. Okay, do you want to fly us back?
Are you sure?
Yeah, you have control. Can you see the industrial estate that's just in front of us there?
The what, sorry?
There's an industrial estate right in front
yeah.
of us there. Just head towards that for me.
Am I heading down or what?
Yeah, I'll control height, you
yeah.
control direction. Okay, you want to bring the nose up and we'll level off. That's it, bring the nose up a bit more. That's it, I'll try and get rid of some of that pressure. Does that feel better?
I don't know. I don't know if I'm doing it right.
It's looking good to me.
So am I just trying to keep the nose with the level with the horizon?
That's it, keep the horizon level and pointing towards the direction we want to go.
How do I get it more that way?
Okay, so roll the aircraft left and then roll the aircraft right. Is that better?
Yeah.
Now, try not to line the nose up with where it is that you're going. Are you trying to line the nose up with the...
Yeah.
Because for me, I'm pointing that way. Use the cowling, see the air vents?
Yeah.
Use the air vents. Imagine you're aiming down the rifle.
Oh, right, okay.
Because the nose is tapered, it points in that way.
Yeah.
You're doing all right. How do you think you're doing?
I don't know if I'm going the right way or not.
Yeah, we're definitely going the right way. Now, can you see our airfield directly in front of us? It's like a flat green area.
Oh, yeah.
That's where we're ultimately heading. That's our destination. I'm just going to speed the aircraft up a little bit more. That's it. Roll your wings level there for me. That's it. Darley, more traffic. Golf Tango Zulu approaching from the northeast for a standard over adjoining runway 19. Copy the industrial estate. Try not to pull back on the stick too much.
Sorry?
Try not to pull back on the stick too much and allow the... That's it. So now the nose has come down, the aircraft's going to speed up.
Is that good?
That's good, yeah. If we fly too slow, we drop out the sky. If we drive too fast, then the wings come off. That's it. Now, can you just see the golf course just over here on our right-hand side?
Yeah.
So when we just clear the this industrial estate beneath us, we'll do a gentle right-hand turn and head over in that way. And that should put me right on the runway. You're doing really well.
Thank you.
There's been no screaming or nothing.
Is that me?
No, it's okay, that's okay. You're sneaking the aircraft over for me, perfect. You see, all I'm trying to do now is bring us further this way so that we can line up on the runway. Darley Moor traffic, Golf Tango Zulu is joining long final runway 19.
Do I need to do any more turning or?
No, that's good, just leave that exactly there.
Yeah.
The wind's blowing this direction, so it's pushing us that way.
Yeah.
Okay, I'll take control from here.
Oh, got a bit of a sweaty hand there.
And now all I'm going to do is set us up so that we can hopefully land on that runway. What do you think?
Yeah.
And we'll make it from here?
Yeah.
Yeah, me too. So we're a little bit high, so I'm going to lose a little bit of height. The easiest way to do this is to come down sideways.
You're doing a combination of things there, aren't you?
I am, yes. I'm kicking the rudder around to ask it to go right, and I'm rolling the wings to ask them go left. So, cross controls.
Yeah.
Keeping the nose down to maintain airspeed. It's a bit of a challenge. First stage of flaps in there just to slow the aircraft down. Now, if I'm not happy with this at all in any way, we'll go straight through to full power and we'll come back around and have another go. Stage of flaps, feel the brakes come on. Better than that, could we? A little bit of a crosswind come through, so we'll just set up for a crosswind landing. A few little bobbles could contend with. And now, just bringing the nose up, try not land it like a Ryanair pilot. That'll teach me.
Oh, nicely done.
Hey.
Woohoo!
Clean the flaps.
It's very nippy, isn't it?
It is very nippy, yeah. Okay, brakes are set, dead cuts on the mags, they're all good. You can take your headset off now.